I'm going to show you how to collect the Windows event logs. These logs are available on all Windows operating systems. They act as a central repository for the operating system and other applications to log events. Many Pi system components log their messages to the Windows event logs, including the Pi AF server, the Pi analysis service, Pi integrators, Pi connectors, and more. If your issue involves a Pi interface, the Pi buffer subsystem, or the Pi data archive, you'll have to collect the Pi message logs instead, as shown in the previous video, how to collect the Pi message logs. Before you start, you'll need the following. First, you need to figure out which computer to gather the logs from. This needs to be the computer where the application having the issue is installed. Next, you need to decide the time range for which you'll be collecting the logs. Make sure that the time at which your issue occurred is included in the range you're collecting. For example, you can collect one day before and after the time of your issue. Finally, since the Windows event logs contain multiple different log files, you'll have to figure out which logs to collect. Before we do an example, let's look at the different types of logs found in the Windows event logs. To view the Windows event logs, go to your Start menu and type Event Viewer. Go ahead and open up this application. The Windows logs are sorted under two categories, Windows logs and Applications and Services logs. Let's expand these two. The Windows logs folder contains logs that track important events about the operating system. Under System, you'll find messages about when the computer and applications started, stopped, and even crashed. Under Security, you'll find information about which accounts attempted to log into the system or access resources on the computer. The application logs will contain even more information about when applications crash. Some applications on the computer will also log all of their messages to the application log. However, many other applications write their messages to a dedicated log file under Applications and Services. In this case, since we're logged on to a Pi AF server, we have an AF log under Applications and Services. Now for example. Let's say I'm having an issue with my Pi AF server. The Pi AF application service has crashed sometime within the last 24 hours. We're already logged on to the right computer, which is the Pi AF server. So which log files do we need to collect? Of course, we'll want to collect the AF log, since it will contain the last messages posted by the Pi AF server before it crashed. But we'll also want to collect the application log and the system log, since these will contain more information about the application's crash and also what else was happening on the system when the issue occurred. As you can see, you often have to collect more than one log file. To view and collect the Windows event logs, simply select the log in the left pane. If you're troubleshooting on your own, you can browse through the messages in this pane here. Make sure that the time of your issue is included in the date and time here. To save the log, simply click on Save All Events As in the right pane. Make sure to give your log file a meaningful name. Make sure to also save your file as the default event file type. Finally, select your display information, and you're done. One last thing I want to point out is that sometimes log files can be quite big. For example, you can see that the application and system log are both 20 megabytes. So we might want to filter these logs before we save them if we can't send a file that's this big. Let me show you how to do this. First, select the file, and then you'll want to click on Filter Current Log. To filter based on time, select the first drop-down menu and select Custom Range. I want to collect the logs from the past 24 hours, so I'll select this From drop-down menu, select Events On, and change the date to yesterday. I can also change the time here if I want to. Since I'm collecting for the last 24 hours, I'll keep my To field to Last Event. You can then save this filtered log by clicking here. Once I've collected all three log files, I'll be ready to continue troubleshooting my issue, and if necessary, get help from tech support.